make the world's most energy-friendly microcontroller. That was my vision. It came to me as I reached the summit of Margherita Peak in Uganda's Mountains of the Moon. I was exhausted, but excited by the adventure ahead. Energy Micro was born on May 17, 2007. It was on the National Day of Norway. I began to plan for ultra-low power applications, the world's most energy-friendly 32-bit microcontrollers, based on an ARM Cortex-M core. And we call it the EFM32. First, I needed a CTO with a technical mind and creativity to help make it happen. Øyvind Janbu was the man. It took me 3 months to get him. There were soon two more co-founders, Erik Jørgensen and John Helge Fjellheim. By December 2007, another 7 people were ready to join the team. Some big strategic goals were set, 24 of them, in fact, to be achieved in the first 10 years. 5 years on, and a half of them had already been achieved. They've been vital to Energy Micro's rapid growth. We continued to add to the team during 2008, and we soon outgrew our tiny office. We worked hard on the specification for the EFM32. Before they were even finalized, we had signed our first customer contracts. Now we were certain that we were on the right track. Gecko was chosen as the name for our first microcontroller product range. A tiny green lizard, the Gecko, at rest using a tenth of the energy of similarly sized mammals. A perfect name.
The design for the EFM32 Gecko would be built from scratch, with complete focus on maximizing energy efficiency. The CPU, the architecture, peripherals, sleep modes, all would need to be state-of-the-art. Partnering with industry-leading suppliers was critical to our strategy, most notably ARM, TSMC and ASE.
It was vital to have a flat company structure at Energy Micro, to ensure that everyone has the opportunity to speak and to influence and to contribute to the success of the company.
So, writing songs of a guide has become a tradition. There's probably one new song a year. I guess it's a good thing when employees can poke fun at the boss. We even sang at the launch of the EFM32 Gecko at ARM TechCon in October 2009. No amount of champagne could have hid the embarrassment, but at least no one will forget it.
With that first product launch, Energy Micro was out of the stealth mode. And for the very first time, engineers had microcontrollers with 32-bit performance that used a quarter of the energy of existing solutions. And we provided software and hardware tools too, with Simplicity Studio, enabling engineers to debug system energy consumption in real time, another industry first. Sales increased rapidly, and we opened sales offices around the world and created a global distribution network.
Invaluable feedback from a growing customer base meant we could always tailor new and unique features. Customers demanded a low energy sensor interface, well, we built it. They wanted more memory, we added it. Increased clock speeds, not a problem.
By 2011, just 2 years after the first product launch, we had introduced 160 microcontroller products. Just the right time for us to begin work on the EFR Draco, the world's most energy-friendly, high-performance radio solutions, the perfect companions for EFM32 Geckos. By creating revolutionary products that enables all things to be smart, connected, and energy-friendly, we will reach our $1 billion revenue goal by year 2020. Energy Micro, our partners and customers, have come a long way in 5 years, but we have many more mountains to climb. Thanks to all of you that have supported us. If we remain as committed, energetic and strong in the next 5 years, I'm sure that we together will reach our goals.